Okay, so you just got a Netflix deal, but you blew all your budget on catering, and now you only have 10 minutes to make a title sequence for your true crime documentary. Well, you've come to the right place. Now, I love title sequences, even if they are just extreme close-ups of barely thematically relevant 3D objects rotating slowly for 60 seconds too long. In this video, I want to show you a whole bunch of techniques that you can use in After Effects to mimic the look you see so often, particularly in crime documentaries, but also add a nice bit of production value to basic scenes. And you can download this project file for free down in the description, just without the stock footage. So we're going to start in an empty composition and start by creating a new solid with Control Y, and let's make it a light gray color. Now let's create a vignette. Now there is a vignette effect over in effects and presets, but you're going to have more options if you create one yourself, first by starting with another new solid. Let's make this one black, and then select our ellipse tool up here in the toolbar and double click it. That will make a mask the size of your comp. We want to set it from add to subtract, press F on our keyboard to bring up its feather, and then feather the heck out of it. About 750 feels nice. Then if you double click that mask, you can adjust it to get the look you want. Then the text. So let's select our type tool and click in our composition and type our title, and then click our align panel and align it to the center. And then we want to pick a font. Nothing too fancy. You want it to be nice and mild for a general audience. Franklin Gothic is a beautiful typeface that is very welcoming and is also available at Adobe Fonts. And now we want to increase that tracking, which is the space between all of the characters. If we go from 0 to 100, that space is doubled, but that is far too subtle. We're making a serious title, so we need to go all the way up to at least 600. More than you think is reasonable is just about right. And now we're going to animate the tracking to be even wider. So now let's hold Control and click the arrow just to the left of our layer down here. And next to animate, we want to click the arrow here and add a tracking property. Let's keyframe the tracking amount at the start. And then about 5 seconds in, let's increase that by 40%. So now it starts really wide and slowly gets even wider. Very dramatic, yet somehow tasteful. And I think we do want to have about 1 second before our title appears on screen so we can add some nice footage. So let's drag this layer over 1 second and let's trim the end of our comp to about 5 seconds as well. 5 seconds, I think, is the perfect amount of time for a title sequence. Anything else is far too indulgent. Now let's add some texture. Now I've got this scanned image of some painted paper that I use all the time, and that is included in the project file too. So let's drag that into our main comp, set its blending mode to screen so we can see through the dark areas, and then let's add a curves effect to adjust the contrast. There we go. And let's animate the scale. Let's have it end at 100%, and then at the start, take it down a little bit, maybe to 85. There, that adds a bit of depth and a bit of grunge. Just so the audience knows what's coming in the show will be pretty grim and dark. This is not a nice sleek white collar crime that the show is portraying. This is one of the bad crimes. So to add more depth, we are going to duplicate this layer with Control or Command D, and we're going to add parallax by increasing the scale of this one faster. So let's select both of these keyframes. Let's go to the start and increase the scale amount so it starts at about 140%. And then at the end, let's increase this one too, maybe a bit more, maybe a touch over 200. So now I've got two layers of texture and the top one is larger and getting larger faster. So it's got more parallax and appears to be a bit closer to us, much more depth. And let's also rotate it a bit so it doesn't match up exactly with the one below it. And we can maybe add a Gaussian blur effect to this one too. Maybe 2 pixels, just a little bit so it feels a tiny bit out of focus, and maybe increase that contrast a little bit more. And now we're gonna add our secret weapon. But first, a quick word about this video's sponsor, Milanote. Milanote is a web app, a brilliant free web app where you can easily organize your motion design and any other projects using their interactive visual boards where you can track your projects from beginning to end. Its interface is really simple and practical. You can just drag and drop. For research and reference, you can create stunning mood boards. It's a great place to put your storyboards. They've got a huge range of templates for you to get started with, and if you prefer your storyboard simple, you've got that. If you want to include more information and direction so your clients don't get too ahead of themselves, you've got that option too. And one reason I think it's particularly great for storyboarding is because you can simply replace and rearrange scenes really super easily. And the collaboration features are also top notch. You can comment, leave suggestions, place arrows, and even sketch freely over the top of your board. And you're in total control of who can edit, comment, or give feedback on any of your boards. So if a particular client is giving a bit too much feedback, you can just restrict their access. And you can also send a secret link to any of your boards with no sign up required to view. For this project, I did a lot of research to find the familiar elements that a lot of these title sequences had. I took the best parts, the most interesting title sequences, and the most common elements from the more generic ones. I kept a growing list of what elements I'd need to include, I decided what color palette I was after, and even how I wanted it to sound.
Crime.
So when I was ready to start animating this project, I already knew all the elements I needed and the animation went as smooth as butter. Milanote have also generously offered to give away a full year of their pro subscription to 3 viewers who sign up using the link down in the description. And now we're going to add our secret weapon, light leaks. If you search on any stock website, you are going to find loads of these. Even on YouTube, you're going to find heaps that you can use. I found this one, which has a bit of a flickering film look, which will be nice and grungy. So let's drag that over the top of everything and set its blending mode to screen. There, how good does that look with barely any effort at all? Now, it's a bit too intense for the whole scene though, so we're going to need to fade it out. But we do want it to be pretty bright for when our title appears here, so we can kind of smooth that transition. So let's drag this across until we find a place where it's pretty bright. Here seems pretty good. So now let's keyframe its opacity. Let's start at 100% at around the 1 second mark. And around 2 seconds, let's lower that to about 10. Now we're not lowering it to zero, so now we get just a tiny subtle bit of flickering, which I think helps. And let's ease those keyframes with F9. And then for the last second, let's increase the opacity as well, so we get more flicker at the very end. There, that is looking lovely and grisly. And for our title popping on, let's just animate its opacity fading up as well. So it is a little more of a smooth transition, and ease those keyframes as well. There, that feels nice. Now let's add some footage to our sequence. I really want this imagery to be specific to this TV series, so it shouldn't feel too familiar or generic. So I went to a stock site that I'm subscribed to and searched the word crime. We've got someone walking very slowly with a car behind them. Could this person be the victim, the criminal? Perhaps this stock videographer's most compliant friend? I'll leave that up to you. I also found this footage of someone poorly cleaning a window, which while technically is not a crime, it isn't a very productive use of their time at all. And then this sequence of fingerprints, which actually does look pretty cool. So I've imported those into After Effects, and let's place the fingerprint behind our text and behind our vignette as well. And let's start that as soon as our title comes on. Now let's set that blending mode to screen, so we just see the white of the fingerprint, and it's animating pretty fast. So let's right click and choose time stretch, and let's change the stretch factor from 100 to 400. So that will stretch it out 400%, so it plays back at 25% of the speed. There, much less painful to look at. Now at the very start, let's add our walking scene, and let's slide that more over towards the right, and then we want to add the invert effect, so it is much more mysterious and chilling. And then let's add a hue and saturation effect as well, and just bring down the saturation. There, and let's set the blending mode to multiply, so we just see the dark areas. And now let's trim it to end at 1 second behind this light leak, and let's animate its opacity, reducing for its last few frames as well. And of course, ease those. There we go. Now let's drag in our inept window cleaner, slide them over to the left, and let's add the same effects and set to multiply as well. Maybe we don't desaturate this one quite as much, and let's change the hue so it fits our background a little bit more. So our title sequence is now looking pretty close. We just need to add some final effects to bring it all together. So let's select our top layer and then go up to layer, new adjustment layer to create a new adjustment layer over the top of everything and call that effects, because we always label our layers. And we're going to add a subtle color grade to this by adding the curves effect. Let's change the red channel and bump up the reds in the shadows a little bit and take down the blue in the highlights to give it a nice subtle sepia tone. And sepia is that slightly brown tint that the past tended to happen in. And then we can add our blur, and we're going to add the best blur that money can buy that also comes in After Effects, and that is camera lens blur. But be warned, this will slow down After Effects a lot. This is a very render heavy effect, but our series deserves the best. So let's start really blurry at a 5 pixel blur radius, and let's keyframe that decreasing from 1 second and to maybe 3 seconds. And let's go down to a 2 pixel blur radius. Now I do like to keep it a bit blurred, so it does help soften the whole image and it doesn't feel so sharp and digital, but that is up to you. But you do want to make sure you have repeat edge pixels selected. so we don't get these pale halos at the very edge of our frame right here, like they did from leaving it unchecked in the Walking Dead titles for season one. And let's easy ease those keyframes, and let's have it blur back up at the very end as well. There, I love that blur effect, and it doesn't bother me too much that the first second is almost completely blurred out. Maybe that adds some mystery and is thematic to the series, because the case is so out of focus with leads that go nowhere for at least the first 7 episodes, as is the focus of those directing and editing the series that have to pad 20 minutes of content out to 10 55 plus minute episodes, otherwise their Netflix checks won't clear. Season 2 of Making a Murderer was much longer than season 1, and bugger all happened except for this woman buying a used car. And then we are going to add a final effect, which is noise. And I think about a 6% noise is nice, but I do have a soft spot for noise. And of course you can tweak all of these settings to dial in the look that you want, as long as you don't make it too original. And there you have it, a crime documentary title sequence in no time at all. And of course you can grab this project file for free down in the description to take a deeper dive and have a closer look at all the effects. I cannot provide the stock footage, but why not film some yourself? If you'd like to learn animation and motion design techniques, I've got a playlist of some of the best tutorials on this channel for you to take a look at. I'll see you in the next one.